Who do you think would have a better idea of the quality of MLS? You or Henri? Well, the actual answer is neither of us. I would actually pick current MLS coaches, current MLS players, and current MLS analysts, but not just them, also scouts of teams around the world that are scouting players in MLS, all of which don't really agree with Henri's position. But why are you guys so insistent on this? Well, easy answer. It's an appeal to authority fallacy. You're appealing to Henri's authority because he was a great player back in his day. So because of him being a great player back in his day, he has to be right. He doesn't even have to make real arguments. He just gets to assert it so, and then it's true. And the problem with this is not only are you guys saying we're going to throw out all our critical thinking skills and just accept what he says as dogma, you guys are actually behaving like sheep, but the reality is you guys are complete hypocrites about this because you disagree with ex-players all the time. I hope none of you ever criticized this guy or said that his tactics were bad or that he was a bad coach or anything like that, because you want to know something? He played in the Premier League and he also played for England. He knows way more than any of you. He knows more than I do. He definitely does. And he's actually a very successful coach in the highest level of international soccer. He's coached England to a World Cup semifinal and two European finals. I mean, his credentials are through the roof. In fact, his coaching credentials are way better than Henri's. But did you guys just say that he's the best in the world, give him the benefit of the doubt and all that? No, of course you didn't. You trashed him and said he sucked and called him an idiot and all those things because you're hypocrites. But the truth is you don't have to agree with every pundit on TV just because they used to be a professional player. In fact, they disagree with each other all the time. Even in the interview you're talking to, the other former MLS player, Mike Grella, largely disagreed with Thierry Henry in the end. But the thing is that you guys only do this when it confirms your bias, and because you lack any basic critical thinking skills, you think an appeal to authority fallacy is the end-all be-all of actual arguments. So, is the American talent in MLS worse than it was back when Thierry Henry was playing? The answer is just simply no. We can look at the players, and the players today are better than the average American player that was back in MLS back in the day. The only real argument that could be made is this. At the time Henry was playing, Landon Donovan was in MLS, and he's arguably the best American player, but he's kind of an outlier. Clint Dempsey had returned to MLS after having a long career in England, and also Michael Bradley had returned to MLS after having a career in Europe as well. However, when we look at the base level talent in MLS now that's American, we have players like Walker Zimmerman, Miles Robinson, Matt Miazga. We have players like Jesus Ferreira. We have players like Duncan McGuire right now at Orlando City is a young and upcoming player. We have players like Jordan Morris and Paul Arriola. They're good players. And we have more. We have Zach Steffen, who is a USA Men's National Team goalkeeper. And we have Patrick Schulte at Columbus Crew right now. So right now, is the American talent in MLS better than it was in 2010 to 2014? Probably. It probably is. And the league on the whole is also substantially better than it was in 2010, 2014. This is really not up for debate. The stats and data don't lie. The MLS is just a significantly better league overall. But you guys don't really care because Henri said so, and you're not even going to argue what he actually argued because you don't care about facts. You care about hating on Americans. But at the end of the day, have a good one. You're just going to talk shit in the comments because you don't know how to make an argument.